pray on Christmas that the Lord will see me through.
Here the parade has actually stepped off at Maplewood and Middlebelt. It is amazing to see. It is a very, very cold day, and we'll get into the numbers later. But it's amazing to see how many people are out here for this parade. We can even see more people in the distance closer to Ford Road. But, Susie, we talked about this on the pre-parade special. As kids, this was the thing to do, and a year off has not affected this parade at all.
No, in fact, it looks like we are back and in stronger numbers, which is just wonderful. We've been waiting for this a long time, so we're finally here today, and we are so looking forward to just a wonderful parade and ultimately reminiscing about some 60 years of what we've done in the past, but it's about today, and we're going to do it.
All right. Again, this is the 60th parade. We did take last year off for the pandemic, but we are thrilled that we have 65 entries in this year's parade. Some of the favorite entries that everyone loves, the Star Wars guys, the Ghostbusters, two marching bands, including Taylor and Garden City, and of course Santa Claus. So we're looking for an amazing parade here today on the streets of Garden City.
We are, and you said it's cold outside. Well, what's a little bit of, you know, what's a cold temperature? Our hearts are warm, our hands are a little chilly, but that's okay. And we are snuggling up and getting ready for just a wonderful experience. Can't wait.
All right, we better get this thing started because there's some snow on the radar that is possibly going to get here around 12 or 1 o'clock. So hopefully we can get this thing in and done before the cold weather, the colder weather, I guess. And as you can tell, I sound like I'm going through puberty. I've got laryngitis here today, so we're gonna battle our way through it. As we can hear, the parade has stepped off from the corner of Maplewood and Middlebelt, and we are just about ready to go with the 60th Garden City Downtown Development Authority Santaland Parade. A great crowd on hand. Our thanks to the Garden City DPS, the Garden City Police Department, the city itself, all of the volunteers we have here today. What an amazing job they've done in getting this parade ready to go here in Garden City on the Saturday after Thanksgiving.
Truly excited about this day, and we thank those of you that are watching us at home today. We know that everybody can't physically be here, but for those that are watching at home, we're going to give you a great show. For those that are here on the sidelines, just a wonderful experience to share together. We are making new parade memories, talking about the past 60, but we're going to make some new memories today. And also, we say a special thank you and welcome to everybody that is marching in the parade. So lots of opportunities. It could not happen without our sponsors. We want to say a special thank you to our title sponsor, the Garden City Downtown Community. Downtown Garden City, a perennial favorite. And let's talk about those sponsors, especially our title sponsor.
And that is the Garden City DDA. They have been our title sponsor for a long time, and we thank them very much for that. At different levels, we have Ken Bocelli, the Bocelli Group. They donated $3,000 to this year's parade, and we thank them, Ken Bocelli and his folks, as always, a helpful contributor to this parade. Ken handles a lot of the building department work for the city of Garden City. Thanks to Garden City Hospital, they contributed $1,500, again, a perpetual donor to this parade, and we thank them so much for their continued contributions. Thanks to Garden City Pawn, a second year sponsor, $1,000 again this year. We thank Tom and everybody at Garden City Pawn for their contributions. These are big, big sponsors and big dollar amounts that they donated to make this year's parade possible. Our thanks to Incorporate Graphics. They are a $700 in-kind sponsor for this year's parade, and Jim Neve and Sharon Giangrani and all of our friends over there. Our $500 level sponsors, John Santu and Son. Of course, John, a great member of this community. Orange Jewelers, the Garden City Medical Center, thanks to Dash. Rashida Tlaib, one of our contributors this year, our local congressperson. Westland Car Care, American Pavement Song, J&J Taxes and more. That's John Fleming and Susan Iani and our friends at Gordon Chevrolet. And $250 from Midwest Cardiology and $100 from Garden City Ace. So our thanks to all of these sponsors that have made this parade possible. What an amazing thing they have done by helping make this year's parade a possible event. And as you see, the parade has begun with our American Legion Ritual Team Post 396.
And our Santaland banner to kick things off. There's a nice aerial shot of what's to come. We say a special thank you and welcome to our Garden City High School AFJ ROTC. You know, that program helps students to become developed citizens of character dedicated to serving the nation and the community. Cadets last year volunteered over 1,200 hours in community service. They are very involved in competitions with drill meets, physical fitness challenges, etc. And don't they look dapper in their uniforms?
And right behind them, the Garden City Junior Air Force ROTC.
And we hear the revving of those engines coming up behind our dapper group here.
And that's the American Legion Riders, the original American Legion Riders post in the country began right here in Garden City.
And interestingly, Dan, I hear us say that just about every year, but for some reason it just didn't hit home until I read it in my binder today. We are the first for a lot of things in Garden City, and very proudly, the American Legion Riders as well.
And we thank the Garden City DPS for setting up that bucket truck for us to be able to get that street shot straight down Middle Belt Road looking north. And right behind the American Legion Riders is the Garden City Fire Department.
Woohoo, here they are. We have Engine 10, which is a new engine purchased through a FEMA grant. It's a custom-built engine to our community. First one, it's a 2018 Ford F-250 with a Braun box. All I know is that means that it's going to keep us safer. It's custom-made, purchased through a bond, and it replaced an older one. But, oh my goodness, they sound like they know what they're doing, and they certainly look beautiful on this special day. We always say this is the one and only time we really want to see our fire department out in full force, and here they are.
Got some youngsters riding along in the fire truck.
Merry
and
Christmas.
You see the fire dog with the trophy that the fire department won at the departmental competitions the last time we had them in September.
Hi, Sparky, welcome to the parade. Woo!
And Kathy Harmon, the fire chief, riding behind Sparky.
Hi, Kathy. Welcome to the parade. Aw. Love it. It's so exciting to see so many people lining this road, Dan.
This is a nice crowd. And you don't actually see the bigger crowd right here on television. The bigger crowds are up the street in front of Kroger and by Ford and Middle Belt.
Yeah, but I'm liking this crowd. I wonder if this crowd can make some noise so we can hear how loud you sound while you're out there. Everybody ready to enjoy the parade? Let's hear it. Make some noise, crowd.
There you go.
Woohoo! That's awesome. Well, we are celebrating the 60th parade, and again, as we talked about some of the reminiscences, the beautiful special that your team put on last year honoring the different decades of the parade, Dan, still available to watch, I know, online, but that was tremendous. But there is nothing like being here in person, and what a welcome back.
Absolutely, and there you see Glenn Anderson's vehicle. He is our Wayne County Commissioner. I'm not sure where Glenn is. I'm sure he's walking somewhere along the parade route. His driver says, back there.
Glenn's in his fifth year as our commissioner, and he represented Garden City in the Michigan State Senate for 8 years. His wife, Gail, as we mentioned, is with him today. And we welcome our dignitaries from all the way from the top all the way to our maybe
we're
wannabe
say the
dignitaries.
Bottom?
No, to the younger wives, the older ones. I'm looking at Rick Hammer in the shot, and I'm thinking I can't say the older ones.
This almost turned ugly, I mean.
Yeah. No. No, it's all good.
And as you said, there is Richard Hammer, our district court judge. We talk about this all the time, but the fact that there has been a Hammer in that seat forever, either him or his father.
That's what I was talking about. Pretty cool stuff.
As you see Mark Jacobs and Brian Earl and members of the Garden City City Council, Mayor Randy Walker up there with them.
Nice to see our team, our represented leaders out and about on this very special day, which many would argue is the most important day in Garden City. I would argue that. Yeah, we would both argue that.
The mayor's wife, Linda, driving his F-150 in the parade. See Melissa DeMichael. Is my voice still cracks?
Doing just fine.
Pat Squire is a member of the parade committee, following up in a golf cart.
She's keeping it between the lines, right down the middle there. Love it. Oh, look at the sweetheart.
And then Jay Lee Lynch with her grandson, Oliver. Oliver's mom, Megan, is part of our crew for today's parade as she handles the stage managing right here on Middle Belt Road. Oliver looks pretty happy to be here.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of stage crew, you all would not probably believe how much effort goes into putting on a parade at this caliber, but the effort that it takes to cover a parade of this caliber is equally as awesome. And so we want to say a special thank you to all of the people that put this parade on the tech side of things to make it as wonderful and accessible as it is today.
There you see Mike Downey driving the Zamboni from the Garden City Ice Arena in the Parks and Recreation Department.
Yeah, the Parks and Rec Department now consists of the Ice Arena and Maplewood Community Center, as we know. The Ice Arena offering lots of programs, learn to skate and all that kind of thing, hockey and so on. And the Maplewood Community Center, of course, located off of Merriman between Ford and Warren, a variety of programs, Dance Express, the Home Pantry, Nerf Wars, and so much. And then we cannot forget the important Family Resource Center, also located at the Maplewood Community Center. They have so many wonderful programs for local youth, including their RAVE, their academic support, life choices, and so many more. Garden City Park and Parks and Rec coming in a big way every day in this community, but today especially. Love seeing them out here.
And there you see the dancers' studio next up here in the parade.
Celebrating 42 years, and it is the 11th year in Garden City. They offer classes in a variety of subjects for different ages and age-appropriate music, costumes, choreography, and they love performing in the Santaland Parade every year, as you can tell. They missed not being here last year, but are making up for it this year. Let's watch them dance. Remember, lots of opportunities to get involved in all of the different organizations that are going to be represented here at the parade, and that is one of the things, as we say, that makes Garden City so very special. We are not the type to sit on the sidelines and watch, except on parade day, of course, but if something sparks your interest, get involved, be a part of this community in a bigger way, perhaps, than ever before, as we celebrate a beautiful day here in Garden City with our 60th Santaland Parade. And welcome to all of our guests walking in the parade as well. Our four-legged friends and our two-legged friends.
So you see the Garden City Figure Skating Club.
You know, they're here developing champions both on and off the ice and in life as well. They offer a learn to skate program for people of all ages. So if you thought, nah, I can't quite do that, I need both feet on the ground, well, give it a try. These kids are making it look very easy with their inline skates.
Garden City Figure Skating Club has been around forever.
And a day.
At least since you and I were kids.
Mm-hmm.
You talked about the setup and everything and all the people who work on this broadcast. This was the coldest week we have ever had to set up. Sometimes you have a couple of cold days, but it was cold every single day this week.
Yeah, just the one thing that's missing, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, and it's coming.
Later today, hopefully.
During the Michigan-Ohio State game. Mm. Now it's Autos for Autism and the students from Berger School.
This is an amazing float. It is entitled Six Decades of Christmas, Berger Schools, Autism Style. It's a wonderful theme. Many thanks to Patrick Crosby and Amy Swarthart for overseeing the making of this float. And you know, we in Garden City are proud to have Berger School for students with autism in our community, one of the largest public school programs in the nation specializing in this kind of education for students affected by the disorder. Enrollment of about 340 students from 33 Wayne County districts. And they are very involved in a variety of different components of activities in Garden City, including Autos for Autism, which we'll look forward to next season. And we are going to see some of those Autos for Autism vehicles coming up soon. Next year will be their 22nd show taking place at the middle school, so we look forward to that. But we thank all of the members of the Berger School for Students with Autism for doing wonderful things in the lives of not only the students, but the community.
If you happen to make it to the Autos for Autism this year at the middle school, they didn't have enough room for all of the cars that showed up. That was an amazing event, and just, you know, they had it at the middle school and tried to use the grass for the middle school, and they used up every bit of it, I'll tell you.
Yeah, we were there as well. I was actually kind of shocked that it has become such an event, such a big event, but that's just wonderful, and raising all kinds of funds for a wonderful cause. Beautiful vehicles.
And this is where you and I,
I knew it was
totally
coming.
Fall down when it comes to the types of cars they have here.
You've got your hot rod. There he is. Woo! Watch those crazy drivers. We got the hot rod. We got the sporty
Jamie said there's an Impala.
Okay. Well, that's
a Mustang.
Look at that.
I have no idea what that one is.
Pretty sweet, though.
I think it says Bel Air on the side. That's a cool pickup truck. And, you know, we're lucky because obviously they don't like to bring these vehicles out if the weather is bad. Mm-hmm. But they also don't like to bring the vehicles out if there's been salt on the road already.
Ah.
And there hasn't been any salt on the road yet, so that that makes it a lot easier for these folks to bring their vehicles to us.
That's a good point. Love the Christmas tree in the back. This is great. Yeah, my Bessie one day may be in the Autos for Autism. She's going on 12 years and very little rust. My Ford Edge.
Yeah, I don't think a Ford Edge is going to be a classic car anytime soon.
Shucks. Oh, look at that. Love the colors. Love the proud owners. That's always so exciting to see. They take care of these vehicles and are very proud to bring them out, as you mentioned, Dan. And whether we know what each one is called or not, it doesn't matter. We know they look beautiful.
By the way, 30 degrees at parade time. That brings up the Public Service Credit Union.
And they are a full-service financial institution dedicated to serving you since 1952. They are all across the Detroit metro area, including, of course, Garden City. Whether you're looking for something new or to expand your portfolio, check them out. Public Service Credit Union. Glad to have them in our parade this year. Welcome. Oh, this is nice.
And headed up towards us right now is the Taylor High School Marching Band.
Long history of success under the direction of Brian Weiserek and Assistant Director Renee Kusecki. They have traveled all across the country performing, and most recently Nashville, Tennessee.
Ooh, I'm going there next week.
Woohoo! They're going to be performing a couple of Christmas carols for us at this time.
Let's listen to the Taylor High School Marching Band.
Thank you. the Griffins of Taylor High School.
Woohoo!
One of the mainstays of the Garden City Santaland Parade. We're happy to have them back in 2021. Happy to have everybody back in 2021.
Nice.
There you see Clifford, the big red dog. Scooby-Doo.
Keep it nice and warm in there, fur. Love it. You know, we talk about 60 years of this amazing and beautiful parade, Dan, and I was thinking the first year the parade happened, my dad would have been around 30-ish. He's 91 now, amazing guy. He would have been around 30, and we would have had six of our nine kids. I'm a youngest of nine, and so I keep thinking about the context of how we started 60 parades ago and where people were, what they were doing.
Well, your husband's father was involved in the original parade and the whole concept.
I look forward to hearing more of those kind of stories.
And being driven by John Prosh from the Garden City Downtown Development Authority is Ethan Bell and members of the Taylor North Little League team, the Little League champions for 2021.
Woohoo!
Excited to have them here. Ethan, a Garden City resident, had an amazing game. He was the winning pitcher in that championship game that everybody saw.
That was pride, you know, Garden City pride going strong, and certainly wonderful to have him as one of our grand marshals. Ethan Van Bell and the DDA, of course.
And right behind them is the Garden City High School girls basketball team, coached by Michelle Tyree.
Looks like we have varsity and JV.
TJ Hurley, the coach of the junior varsity.
Just love it. Love seeing the orange and the blue represented.
Also the color of the Taylor North Little League.
Hmm.
Coincidence? I think not.
We see Elmo there, and you know, we just absolutely love Elmo, who also apparently happens to live in Garden City, I'm told. I don't know. Is there a story behind that?
I don't know. Is there? Did I miss something in the script?
I don't know. Just tossing it out there for you.
I'm sure Dan will tell a story. No kidding. Okay, we'll have to look at that later.
Yeah.
Here's the Garden City Soccer Club with a really great float.
Oh, this is so cool. The mission of this club is to organize, conduct, and supervise this amazing soccer program for youth in and around Garden City and promote and advance the cause of good sportsmanship through the game of soccer. And it's a volunteer-run organization. Coaches focusing on player development and teaching fundamentals and so on. And we love having them represented in our parade every year.
Like that all of the great other service clubs, like the GCYA, yeah, like the figure skating club. These are all the things that make Garden City what it is. All of these great organizations with all of this involvement from the local residents. This is what makes Garden City the town that it is.
Yeah. You said a mouthful, toots.
There you see a float that was constructed by Derek Van Dorn, who is one of our camera people here today, and Total Lawn and Snow. And it's being driven by Dominic King, who is the father of one of our committee members, one of our crew members, as well as a new member of the Garden City Santaland Parade Committee.
That's a great float. Love it. If we can't have snow, at least we can see snow on the float.
Oh, yeah.
On the floats as they go.
Gibby, how's that radar? How close is the snow getting? Oh, there you go, Susie.
Woo.
I don't think that's all snow, but I think the green is. So there you go.
We'll take it.
This may be a nasty teardown.
Oh, boy. As long as we get the next group coming through before
go
the snow, because,
right,
you know, the Redford.
And that's
Redford
the Redford
Township.
Township Unicycle Club, who, again, they've been in this parade as long as I can remember.
They've been around since 1975, parading and performing really ever since. Wendy Gersh, who is a Garden City resident lifelong, and she is at the helm of making sure that this group does what they're supposed to do with their routine, but also have so much fun in the process. And they are offering classes for beginning riders, and they even provide the unicycles at Tipton Academy. They're going to start some again in January.
Oh, we got some stunts going on here.
Yeah, oh boy. check out
the
website.
See how this goes. There you go.
Okay, that was heart palpitating. Do not try this at home. They are experts.
Oh, we were going to try it at the Christmas party after the parade.
And you're going to be the one laying.
No, we're going to use interns. Oh,
jeez. Oh, boy. Love seeing the Unicycle Club.
As we always tell the interns, we can get more interns, but equipment's expensive.
Oh. Oh, boy.
Happy to have you on our telecast live here on GCTV and, of course, streamed around the world on Facebook and YouTube. And don't forget, folks, at the end of the parade, the DDA has their post-parade event. So if you're watching us live from your living room, you can still get over to that post-parade event in the parking lot next to Planet Fitness, the Garden City Town Center. And you can the kids can visit with Santa and talk with him. So we encourage you to attend that DDA event after today's parade.
Yeah, Santa's got a little bit of an important duty to deal with first, of course. So we will officially welcome him with the two keys to the city coming up in just a bit. But what a parade we've got going on this beautiful, beautiful, crisp morning in Garden City. The Dog Scouts of America, Troop 217, they're the Motor City Canines. And they are a nonprofit group dedicated to positive training and teaching of dogs to be model canine citizens. They work hard. Community service, responsible pet parenting, obedience, and dog sports. And this is Troop 217, as I said, serving a broad area of Southeast Michigan and Northwest Ohio. And they look so sweet in their little Christmas outfits. Oh, my goodness. Shout out to Mackie and also Desi and Lucy, who might be watching today, some of our little favorite pets. Oh, love those Christmas presents. Wouldn't you love a present like that under your tree on Christmas morning? Look at
the little legs going.
So sweet. Dog Scouts of America. We are so happy that you're here today with us celebrating the 60th parade. And again, special thanks to all of those who helped make this happen today, including our sponsors and all of the contributors that are here participating in the parade, whether you're walking, driving, riding, whatever the case may be. So much fun to have you here. The Model A Restorers Club in our shot right now. From 1928 to 1931, many members have more than two Model A's and as many as three or four because they love Model A's, and as they should. Also, special thanks just coming through our shot a minute ago, Blessed Pest Solutions.
You're supposed to say with two syllables,
blessed,
probably.
Blessed, I like that. Blessed or blessed, I think either way, we're happy that they're here. Full service pest control, husband and wife team, and we love it. Welcome to the parade. And here are those Model A's. So nice that we bring in new entries each year, but some of the staples, well, you don't want to miss them. And they come back time and time again. Just love it.
Yeah, these are beautiful. Mm-hmm.
I have to put a wreath on Bessie, I think, this year. I'm doing the best I can with that clunker.
Tell your husband to buy you a new car.
Well, long, long story.
Well, we got like an hour and a half.
I was going to say kind of like that other story that we're going to get to the bottom of later with Elmo.
So Elmo actually asked to be in the parade. I had to remember what that story was, but Elmo actually called us to be in the parade. Oh, it's PKSA Karate. John Prosh, what a great float.
Snowing there. Woohoo. It's like a Hallmark Christmas.
Those poor kids in the front are covered in snow.
That's great. If you're looking for a school committed to teaching traditional martial arts while improving concentration, self-discipline, respect, leadership, and so much more, well, it is PKSA Karate. Get your child involved in one of the only activities that can change their lives, empowering them to be successful in their future. And they deal with self-confidence and discipline and self-esteem. So much more. PKSA Karate, a mainstay in our parade this year. And, well, they brought the snow with them. I love that. That's a celebration. Love to see that.
I think Santa brought his own snow, too.
Yes. Yes, yes, yes.
And PKSA Karate is our float winner for 2021.
Oh, well deserved. Love that.
Garden City Soccer Club finished second, and Autos for Autism finished third. Mm. So congratulations to all of them.
Wonderful lineup. Makes everybody want to step it up again even more next year, too, to keep
That's
that competition
right.
going.
The Michigan Wheelmen in front of us right now.
The Michigan Division is part of an international organization of these beautiful antique bicycle enthusiasts called the Wheelmen, although I see some wheel women there as well. Their purpose is to keep the heritage of American cycling alive, promoting the restoration and riding of early cycles, and encourage cycling as a part of modern living. And the Michigan Division is the number one in membership in the United States and abroad. So we have the biggest Michigan Wheelmen chapter here in Michigan. And if you'd like more information, check out their website, thewheelman.org. Love looking at this. I don't know what would be harder, Dan, this or the unicycle.
It's kind of the same thing.
Well, I don't know. I suppose if we ask
I might have a chance
them,
with this because there's two wheels. I might have a chance. That's the best I can say.
Yet another friendly competition for the interns.
Here's Westland Car Care, one of our new sponsors of this year's parade.
And they are proud to support and service the Garden City community and proud to be in our parade this year. Thank you and welcome to the Westland Car Care Towing. Well, this is just a great day. I'm thinking about past parades, getting ready this morning and thinking about the memories of this one and that one. And one of the things you might not know, Dan, is my mom, who, as she got a little older, would watch the parade from home. And then we would do our thing, and then we'd go. The first thing I would do is go to her house, and she would give me an update or a critique of how we did.
Oh, boy.
The parade was always great. It was like how we did. We always got pretty good marks. But I miss that, and those are some wonderful memories that I'm going to treasure associated with this parade. And it's very exciting to see people that are making new memories for the parade.
Our thanks to Gordon Chevrolet for donating some of the vehicles that we have in this year's parade. Also one of the sponsors. And they're followed up by the Garden City Business Alliance.
Oh, yeah. The Bennett sisters representing these sponsors at Gordon Chevrolet with their bit of festivity. And the Business Alliance has been working together to help us deal with being better merchants, more things for the customers, and really just making Garden City even stronger. And love seeing all those names. What is
now,
that?
Now, instead of an elf on the shelf, is that an elf on the tailgate?
I think it's an aardvark? Is it an aardvark?
No, it's Elf, the thing from television when we were in our in
Elf.
The 80s. Elf.
A-L-F.
A-L-F.
Oh, yeah. That's so clever.
It was a pun and you totally missed it.
I missed it. Well, my eyes aren't so good these days, Dan. It's been, over the years and such. But Garden City Business Alliance, love having them here. And they do so much for the community. Music in the park, trunk or treat. They brought Elf, A-L-L-F, to us today. And that's wonderful. Last Day Dog Rescue, our home foster-based rescue organization out of Livonia, fostering dogs all over the state. Fosters needed for dogs and cats, always. So if you'd like to learn more, lastdaydogrescue.org. Make the life of a beautiful, sweet dog that needs a home. Open up yours to theirs. They're so sweet.
And there's Stan the Magical Fireman.
We love Stan, and Stan's job in this parade, not only to look amazing, is to remind us to be fire safe this holiday season. Stan is known really, universally for teaching fire safety to hundreds of families throughout his magical fire safety show, and also rides on his awesome fire truck. So Stan, welcome back.
So Andrew Rasick on Facebook, who has all kinds of trivia about Garden City. Ah. According to him, I think this came out yesterday or today, this is the 17th consecutive appearance for Stan the Fireman in the Santaland Parade.
Oh, wow.
Now, I can't prove that either way, but that sounds about right.
We will accept it. It was on the internet. We accept it as true.
It must be true.
That's right.
Here's the Garden City Library.
Oh, they are the best value in town. Yes, they are the Garden City Library. You can check out books and DVDs, free checkouts of technology like Chromebooks, Wi-Fi hotspots, Fitbits. They offer crafts and story time events for kids and all sorts of programs. And get your library card if you don't have it yet. All you need is to head over to Maplewood Center with your proof of residency in Garden City and start your adventure with the Garden City Public Library. They will be presenting their summer reading classic car show again next year, and they've got all sorts of things that they're going to be participating in, and they thank the voters of the community for supporting them, and we thank them for everything that they do to help keep us smart and get smarter every day in Garden City.
These classic cars are part of their entry.
That's beautiful.
Oh, there's our Santa cam, and Santa Claus has made it onto Middle Belt Road.
Oh, this is so exciting. Kind of like an elf. Santa!
Oh. Santa on the road.
Wonderful.
As we're about halfway through our 60th Garden City Santaland Parade.
What a beautiful, beautiful day.
And this is Mona's Photography, I believe, located in Taylor. Nice to have them in our parade.
Oh, it sure is. Welcome. They do all sort of events with studio photography as well as location photography, and they are spending their Saturday morning here with us, and we welcome them. Love to see some friendly faces, and they're smiling because, you know, they're photographers, and that's the thing. Gotta keep that beautiful smile going. Welcome to the parade.
And on the other side of the street is Rory, the mascot of the Detroit Lions.
Here comes Rory.
Rory has found his shot.
Okay, now let's be nice.
Rory's coming to visit.
It's not Rory's fault. Rory, you go. Go, baby.
All right. Good luck the rest of the way, Rory. And next up is Robert Lee School of Dance and the Stage Group.
Robert Lee School, located right here in Garden City, and give them a shout if you want more information about all different types of dance classes, supporting talent and giving encouragement. Stage, and they are on stage today. Let's watch them perform. Ah. One way to keep warm, as we always say. Love that. Robert Lee, thank you for coming back again. And thank you to everyone enjoying this parade today with us. There's nothing like the parade live. But, you know, the recorded music that we get to experience during the live events is also pretty exciting. We hear the theme song. It's the Ghostbusters.
Oh, this is a popular event, or a popular group, rather. They've got that Stay Puft Marshmallow Man.
Oh, fantastic. We love our Ghostbusters. They help raise awareness to many charitable organizations, conventions, parades, and other events to help promote happiness and fun in their full Ghostbusters attire with equipment, accessories to help them investigate and eliminate any paranormal entities that may occur. GhostbustersDetroit.com and the Ectomobile. Riding along with, of course, our Ghostbusters song. They have Slimer, as you mentioned, Stay Puft, Terror Dogs, all along for the ride. Who are you going to call, Dan?
Ghostbusters.
Oh, okay. My my mother would have said, he needed a little more energy on that one.
Yeah, but when I do that, I cough. So.
Oh, I get it. Well, thank you then. Thank you for that. We've got the new
Dan's
one.
Dan's having a rough morning.
Oh, it's all right. New Ghostbusters movie coming out, or out now. Can't wait to see that one. It's a staple.
There you see the Garden City Department of Public Service.
Another staple in Garden City doing what they do to help keep us safe and clean on the roads and in our community. And they say Merry Christmas to all of us, and we say Merry Christmas and thank you for your hard work and service to this community.
They'll also be driving the Santa float. Steve Mihalik will be driving that. Thanks to Steve and Brad and everybody at the DPS. They provided the bucket truck for us for our overhead shot. They put bleachers on the other side of the street for us. They provided all kinds of support this week for the Santaland Parade and for the telecast of the Santaland Parade, so we thank them for that.
And that's important, as you've mentioned it, and we've both mentioned it takes an awful lot to put this event together, and could not do it without the work of the everybody in the community pulling their weight.
Lots of new, I get it.
That was a joke.
Lots of new vehicles for the Department of Public Service after not getting many updates. They've had a lot of their stuff updated in the last 2 or 3 years.
Awesome.
And right behind them, another staple in the Santaland Parade, the Taylor Shrine Club Tin Lizzies.
Woohoo! You know, Henry Ford formally introduced his Model T on October 1st, 1908. And it's known for its dependability, soon nicknamed the Tin Lizzie. And the Taylor Shrine Club downriver operates out of Taylor, one of the longest-running clubs in the Muslim Shrine Temple. They are celebrating their 40th anniversary today, parading in these Tin Lizzies all around Southeast Michigan. They raise funds and awareness for 22 Shriners hospitals for children in North America. So they not only get to enjoy doing this kind of stuff, but they are doing it for a very important reason.
Apparently, they've done this long enough to know where the cameras are.
Nicely done. I love how each of these is decorated.
We've even got a teddy bear driving one of them.
Aww. Oh my gosh. Somebody needs to get the teddy bear a fez, though, right? One of those hats. I think that's what it's called.
It is. Nice job.
Thank you.
Also, thanks to Tim Gibbons of the Garden City Police Department for their support. Of course, keeping the roads blocked and keeping us safe during our Santaland Parade.
I know we've talked about watching this on Facebook and enjoying it on local cable. Being here physically in person is incredible, but also there's always an opportunity to watch it after the fact. One of the things that the paraders like to do that are in the parade is enjoy it after the fact as a part of celebrating. Another event to celebrate is the community Christmas tree lighting. Tell us a little about that, Dan.
You'll get to see Santa again as the big Christmas tree in the Commons will be lit up, as well as all of the other decorations that the DDA has put up in the Central Business District. So check that out on Monday at 6:30. I think it's 6:30 or 6 o'clock. I'm not sure. But check it out anyways. Whatever the graphic said. Yeah, check out the DDA's Facebook. See, this will drive traffic to their Facebook.
Oh.
By me being completely incompetent and not knowing what time it is.
Clever.
Girl Scouts.
We are the Girl Scouts. Here they are, leadership organization for girls, giving us unmatched opportunities to lead, design robots in STEM, and do outdoor adventures. Their mission is building girls of courage, confidence, and character. They make the world a better place, and they've been doing so for over 100 years. This is the local group, troops out of Garden City, Westland, and Wayne. We have Troop 1260 and 76193, 77284, and 76859, and we're going to see them all enter the staging area separately, but we are very, very grateful for the Girl Scouts, and not just for your cookies, but for all of the work that you do in just making the world a better place.
And the tree lighting is at 6 o'clock, not 6:30.
Thank
so
you.
6 o'clock. Don't show up at 6:30. And they'll have hot chocolate also.
Very nice. The junior troop from Garden City, by the way, building girls of courage and confidence and so much more. And they've got their high school cookie sale coming up this February. And then we have, I'm trying to see them in the 76859.
Mm-hmm.
They're Daisies and Brownies. And we had St. Anne's Garden City Girl Scout troop walking through as well. I just love seeing them really come together in full force like this. Once a Girl Scout, always a Girl Scout, they say. And we're proud to have them all represented here in our parade.
Were you in the Girl Scouts?
I was not.
Oh,
but
no.
I supported them.
That's
in other
scandalous.
Ways, if you know what I mean.
You
I know.
You bought their cookies as well.
Oh,
Again, don't forget, if you're watching us live, the DDA's post-parade event coming up in the Garden City Town Center, which is located just south of Planet Fitness and the credit union there in the town center. Go see Santa and all kinds of other stuff going on.
And the reason I wasn't in the Girl Scouts is because with nine kids, you kind of had to pick one thing and stick with it, you know.
I so see. That,
and the cheerleading kept me, helped me work off the Girl Scout cookies, in fact. So it was a nice partnership back in the day.
Well, if you want to go to the end of the parade, they have free hot dogs and hot chocolate.
Ooh, snacks.
And you can take a picture of Santa with your own phone.
I like it. I said that word, Dan, that you don't like.
Yeah, I know. I'm just going to let it go.
We love seeing everybody here. We've got celebrities posing for pictures across the way. We've got gingerbread people walking through. And we also have Teddy's Lawn and Landscape, a local business, offering landscape design, maintenance, and commercial snow removal. Maybe we'll need them sooner rather than later if my wish comes true. They've been in business for 27 years, and they employ a lot of Garden City residents and graduates. Garden City grad Brent Teddy is the owner. And check them out, Teddy's Lawn and Landscape, and we're very, very happy to have them in our parade this year. Getting ready for the snow.
Trying to pull up the radar.
Woo-hoo-hoo.
Let's see if we're going to make it.
When you say if we're going to make it, you mean if we're going to get the snow before the parade.
Yeah, we might at the very end.
Yes.
So we may see some snow when Santa gets here, not just the snow machine on the back of the DPS truck.
Glass half full, glass half empty. This is nice. This is so nice. We are very excited to, again, welcome those that are enjoying the parade live on the stands.
There's the Santa cam.
There it is. And we are grateful that they are here to celebrate this most special day. Wondering if the crowd wants to share how many years they've come to the parade. Can we get some shout outs? How many years you've been actively coming to the parade? Do we have anybody that's been here for at least, this is at least your third or fourth parade? At least your third or fourth, okay. How about fifth or sixth parade? Five or six? Okay, I'm gonna jump up. How about 9 or 10? Who's been doing this for 9 or 10 years coming to the parade? Oh my goodness, 10 to 15. Anybody been doing this? Oh, we're seeing it. And how about more, we're gonna stop at 15. How about 15 or more years you've been coming to the parade? Let's hear it. Yeah! That's what I like to hear. Wonderful. See lots of familiar faces and friendly smiling faces in our group today.
So the very first Garden City Parade I went to, this will mean nothing to you, but it will to Brett George. Vern Rule was the Grand Marshal, who was a pitcher on the Tigers.
Oh, my goodness.
Who was the best pitcher on an awful baseball team, but for some reason they could always get him to be the Grand Marshal. Jamie knows that, too, Vern Rule. Here's the Boy Scouts.
Troop 1241 and Cub Scout Pack 753. You know, they meet each week at the Scout House on Middle Belt Road, and they're always happy to welcome new members, boys and girls from kindergarten up to age 17, invited to check out what they do and see what scouting is all about. And we welcome them back to our parade. Love having the scouts here.
As we announce from Announce House.
Ah,
how
Announce
about
House.
That? By the way, we want to thank Emily Gibbons, Christian Gibbons' wife, for decorating the inside of Announce House for us for this year's parade.
Beautiful job, Emily. Nice touch. Very classy.
Hey, look, it's us.
Yay.
Hi. See, we're supposed to be centered in the shop, but I keep moving closer to Susie to stay warm. So.
And I keep going. I'm kidding. Of course not.
Yeah, that's what she did.
Oh, goodness, goodness, goodness. WeSingBarbershop.com. is...
He can hear scrambling.
I know.
I believe it's the Harmony Town Chorus.
Is this the Harmony Town?
There
Yay,
we go.
It is. Okay, a little bit out of our order, but we're so glad that you are here. Established in 1944, the Wayne, Michigan chapter of the Barbershop Harmony Society.
Let's hear it for the Harmony Town Chorus.
Woohoo! They say love to sing? Well, join them. Absolutely. Come visit and enjoy that most beautiful and joyous noise, which is Harmony Town barbershop music. We just love it. It's great to be a barbershopper, as they say, and check them out because they bring joy to the community and they brought joy to this parade.
It's time now for the Great Lakes Garrison, the 501st Legion Star Wars Costuming Group, one of the most popular entries in the Santaland Parade for over 10 years.
Oh, missed them last year. They are here in full force, and it looks like even more this year. I've never seen so many representatives of this Star Wars Costuming Group. They're an all-volunteer organization, and their express purpose really is bringing together costume enthusiasts under a collective identity in which to operate, and they promote interest in Star Wars, of course, through these costumes, and they deal with all sorts of different costume events for Star Wars-related activities, and they contribute to the local community through charity and volunteer work. They're joined by their sister organization, the Rebel Legion, the good guys of the Star Wars universe, and the Mandalorian Mercs, Star Wars bounty hunters. All group members need to build their own costumes and submit them for approval. They look amazing. And this 501st Legion is recognized by Disney and Lucasfilm. They're often called upon to appear in commercials and TV shows and movies as extras. So they are famous and gracing us with their collective presence here at the Santaland Parade. Welcome aboard, everybody.
And our thanks to Mike Leica, who is our Garden City connection to this group. He makes sure that they're back every year.
Just love it. Big year for Star Wars, too. Big year. Very nice.
Again, thanks for joining us for the 60th Garden City Downtown Development Authority Santaland Parade. We're happy that you've joined us live. We are happy that you've joined us either on GCTV on cable or on Facebook and YouTube. Happy to have everybody participating, whether it be virtual or in person, with this year's parade.
And I mentioned a little bit ago about anybody being here for 15 or more years, but you know I have to up that as we go here. Anybody participating in the parade for 20 years or more? Do we have any 20-plus? 20-plus? Oh, we do. Look at that. Oh, my gosh. We'll
keep those
going.
Most of our crew.
On. Yeah. There you go. Not that we're dating ourselves, but... That's okay.
That'll bring up the Garden City Kiwanis Club. John Fleming is driving their vehicle that's pulling their trailer.
Oh, the Kiwanis, a worldwide community service club with the idea of promoting leadership skills in children and helping seniors contribute to obtain their quality of life. And our club, the Garden City Kiwanis, was chartered in May of 1948, and they have been a steady contributor to improve the quality of life for all community residents. Their golden rule that they live by is just promoting life. And we welcome them back. Year after year, love the Kiwanians in Garden City.
And I believe this is the Garden City Soccer Club moving into our camera view. Nope, Garden City Youth Athletic Association. Sorry about that.
GCYAA celebrating 65 years of providing youth sports to Garden City. And they are 100% nonprofit, run by volunteers, offering all sorts of sports. And here are the cheerleaders. I think we've got JV and varsity represented today. Oh, brings back memories. Love it. Just love it.
And just so I don't forget before we go off the air, I want to thank the Garden City Santaland Parade Committee, Kevin Kramus, Monica Fulton, Margo Arnosky, Pat Squires, Mark Randazzo, and Rob Cox. Many of these people have been doing this for 20 years. For some of them, this is their final parade, and we thank them for their contribution over the years. This is the Garden City High School cheerleaders.
We are the Cougar Varsity Team. We're going to rock our team to a victory.
High school basketball starts in a couple of weeks. Actually, I think girls basketball starts next week.
So nice having our sports activities up and running and seeing our school buses and all the kids enjoying what they love doing, which is getting out and about and participating in activity. Love Garden City Public Schools Transportation Department. That's the cleanest bus I've seen in a long time, and it's beautiful. So we thank Garden City Public Schools Buildings and Grounds and Transportation. Not an easy job, I'm sure. So
there you see the high school homecoming court. Kelsey Baker, Mia Borg, Emmy Halam, Olivia Will, and homecoming queen Brianna Taft. Congratulations and thanks for being in this year's parade.
Looking great, ladies. Big smiles, big smiles. There they are.
The girl on the tailgate's got the Miss America wig.
Yeah.
She's got that.
Which I think was inherited from the Queen of England.
Yes.
It's that regal, very regal.
Yes, if I had my voice, I could do my Queen of England voice, but I can't do that.
I didn't know you did the Queen of England.
I do the Queen of England voice.
Sweet. Sweet.
I believe, yeah, there's Sarah Roffey. So this is the Garden City volleyball team that won the Western WAN Athletic Conference again, coached by John Pace.
Wow. Their fourth consecutive conference championship. So happy to have them here. JV was undefeated in conference play, and they achieved Academic All-State 2021, Academic All-America 2020 and 2021 school year. Wow. Glad you're here, girls. We hear the music, Dan. You know what that
right.
means?
Ah! So following them up is the Garden City High School Marching Band. Under the direction of Mr. Parkinson. Glad to have them in the parade. Let's listen. Let's hear it for your Cougar Marching Band. We're thrilled to have the Cougar Marching Band leading our star of the show, Santa Claus, as we come to the conclusion of our DDA Santaland parade. There you see Santa with some costumed characters leading him. Got a Christmas tree and a nutcracker and an elf. Santaland Parade rents those costumes from a company actually in Toronto. And surrounding Santa are students from Douglas School. Ms. Dupree's third grade class, along with some other students. And also thanks to the National Honor Society, who have been a part of this parade this year. You can see the front of Santa's sleigh, the front of Santa's float, covered in snow. So that's probably a prelude of what's to come here at our Santaland Parade.
Merry Christmas! Good to see everyone. Thank you for coming out today.
We want to thank Kelly DePriest for having all of these youngsters show up for the parade dressed as Christmas presents.
Merry Christmas!
I see Ryan and Ken out there.
Hi there, Merry Christmas.
There's Santa.
Thanks for coming to see me. I missed you last year.
There's Steve Mihalik driving Santa's float. We thank him and the DPS for all their efforts. And Susie is going to go up and have a word with jolly old St. Nick, and the mayor has a presentation to make. We thank Ken Hines and the folks from the Kiwanis who have for quite some time now made sure this float is in shape and ready to go. So we thank them very much for that. And Susie, I'm going to turn it over to you.
Thank you, Dan. It's a Christmas miracle, Santa. There's snow in Garden City. Woo-hoo! And you're here. Welcome to the parade. How are you doing?
Well, thank you, Susie. I'm so happy to be here in Garden City, my favorite place to be. You know that. I missed you so much last year. You have enough goodness for 2 years in a row?
Absolutely, of course. Thank you, you know that. Let me mention this. We're so happy to have you back, of course. And we know every child in Garden City has been just wonderful this year.
My book is overflowing. My book is overflowing with Garden City children.
Any advice, though, for those few that are thinking, maybe I can get away with a little sassy before Christmas, because it's right around the corner.
We are watching every day. We got your Christmas drones up there too, but there's still time if you've done something wrong to get back on the good list. Trust me. Be good, be good, be good.
Thank you, Santa. Speaking of being good, because you're the best guy we know, we welcome you, and we also welcome this other great guy, Randy Walker, our mayor, with the key to the city.
Well, thank you. I miss you guys.
On behalf of our good boys and girls of Garden City, I want to present you the key to our fine city.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor, and I cherish this. I got a whole collection up in the North Pole, but Garden City is my number one key.
Woo-hoo! Thank you, Santa. Will you give us a big ho, 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 Merry Christmas?
Oh, Merry Christmas! Ho, 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 ho! Merry Christmas!
Let's hear it for Santa! Woo! Thank you, Santa.
Thank you, Santa. We'll see you on Monday at the tree lighting and also at the post-parade event for the DDA. Thanks for coming back to Garden City, Santa. We love having you here.
So happy to be here.
And thanks to all the kids from Douglas School who are here today.
Merry Christmas! Merry Christmas, Garden City! I love you all!
All right, well, that brings to a conclusion our 60th Garden City Downtown Development Authority Santaland Parade, an amazing parade. So lucky to have the parade back this year. So happy to have the parade back this year in 2021, Susie.
Oh, my goodness. Santa's float looks better than ever, too. It is just stunning. So what a regal way to bring him into this most special day, Dan. Well, all I can say is best parade ever. whatever. How's that?
Very good. Well, we want to thank everyone who volunteered. We want to thank everyone who was a part of our crew this year, and you'll see all of their names in the credits. There's actually too many to mention this year, but thanks to everybody who was out here all week getting the telecast set up. Thanks to all of the volunteers who showed up today to work. Oh, my goodness, it's snowing. It's real snow
it
now.
It is a Christmas miracle, I'm telling you.
Thanks to all
Santa
of the volunteers who helped on the parade route. Thanks to all of the folks at the Department of Public Service and the Garden City Police Department for everything they did. And it truly is actually snowing right now.
Thank you, Santa.
Susie, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Dan.
All right. To everybody in Garden City, we want you to have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Good morning, Garden City.